Hi Lauren, sorry for the delay in getting this to you, but I heard that you could use a little extra time too. I watched your video. It looks wonderful. I'm so proud of you for getting all of those little details so quickly because we've been kind of busting through this really fast. And so all the steps and everything are totally there. The thing that I want to work on today is really finding the stretch through your leg in all of those PKs, relevés, right? You're on your toes all the time with Sugar Plum. So we're going to work on that a little bit today, finding this connection of your heel up into kind of where that little crease in your booty is, where it connects to your leg. Okay, so you want to feel this energy shooting all the way up the back of your leg every time you go up onto relevé. So we're going to work on that today. Point prep day is a perfect day to do that. As usual, since we've started learning Sugar Plum, we're not going to have quite as long of a warm up. So it'll go by pretty quickly, but we're really going to focus on that heel to booty connection. All right, let's get started. Starting with our footies. Turnout, finding that heel into the booty connection. Oh darn, when the music goes away, I don't know how many I've done. We'll say that was eight. Here we go, plie. And here it is, from this position with these knees bent, finding that full stretch. So imagine there is a band connecting your sits bones, that bottom part of your pelvis, to your heels, and they connect up here. Squeeze those inner thighs together. That's really going to help you find that connection and that stretch. Right. Now, I know that that is easier said than done, and it's a lot easier to do on two legs versus one. So as we move into our elevés, trying to feel that same sensation, even though it's quite a bit more challenging. It just takes that little extra energy up at the top. Okay, so we will take, we're at 16, right? Crazy, that's awesome. All right, here we go. Into sugar plum. These two things are about to come into what you're learning of sugar plum. So we are going to take our releves, but we're going to take passe releves, which I think we were starting to work on. The difference is that we are going to, no, you know, we're going to keep it the same. It's, you'll see how it all works out in the end. We'll just go ahead and take three passe releves, third one changes to the back, three passe. Okay, I have a plan, sorry. Three passe releves will change. Again, we'll take the passe releves, but to the back, three passe releves, change. Then we're gonna start to the back on the left, three passe releves, change, and then three passe releves, change. That way we don't lose our bar, otherwise we're moving back, right? And again, this one's a little funky because we're going from a plie, finding that straight up into that super connected, long stretched back of the leg on your supporting leg. Okay, let's give tempo here. Every time. Here we go. Position plie, sits bones dropping straight. find a place where you can be in arabesque facing your bar without your leg hitting anything. And we are going to, I think we may have done this in the past, we're going to take a really stretched PK leg toward our bar, up to find our arabesque. That's about where it ends, what we've done before. Now from here, I'm going to go up and I'm going to change my facing from the bar to the camera, to a passe position, okay? So I'm pivoting my hips. So from my arabesque, nice and sharp, hips and shoulders pivot, finding passe, keeping the turnout in that supporting leg, keeping the stretch in the leg, okay? So we're just going to take up and pivot, hold, hold. We'll set it down and then we'll just take a little step back so that we're ready to go up to the other side, arabesque, then we'll pivot away from the camera to find our passe, okay? It should be nice and sharp from one angle to the other. And when you're bringing that leg in from arabesque, you're keeping it nice and high, lifting from the inner thigh so that we're not getting, right, where it drops down. We want it to stay lifted, nice and sharp. Let's find some music for that, shall we? For you too. And don't forget, if that was too quick for you for the very first few times, use your little slowdown feature up at the top. Never, ever, ever any shame in that, especially when you're trying to get it clean. Okay, let's put our bar away. Now, hopefully you're finding time, even though we're not able to do it in the video, to do your TheraBand stuff. So anytime you're bored or doing something that is using your brain but not really your body, try to see if you can squeeze those TheraBand guys in. Okay, let's walk through what we know already, yes? Although you know it already really well, so we'll walk through it quickly from here to here. Here we go. I'm finding the stretch in this leg before I ever go up, and nothing about that changes as I come up. Same thing here. Bam. And don't fall over like me. Here. So here it is. This is a hard one. Full stretch. All the way up. Plie. Bum bum. Finding that heel to booty connection. Bum bum. And jeté. This is such a hard one, truly, Lauren. This is hard for everyone, no matter how long they have been doing ballet. So think of taking your entire body with you to go back. Sorry, I did the wrong arm. Okay, so you're thinking of keeping your body connected over this back leg. And if you're not thinking about your body, it's going to become difficult, right? Because it's going to keep falling forward, butt's going to start sticking out. So you want to feel almost like there's a wall behind you here. And you are sticking your body against it. So you want to almost fall back a little bit there, okay? So back, 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 back. This was so pretty and released. Really, really lovely.
finding that full stretch though here at the top. Ooh, leaning toward the leg. Forward, leave. From here, attitudes were lovely. Don't forget, you want to scoop with that same arm as attitude leg reaching. So here, and I'm really leaning with that shoulder, like I'm trying to almost look around my wrist. Here, step, step. To this position, your precipites were lovely. Susu, precipite, susu. This was very nice. See if you can make them just a little bit sharper. And from that bore, finding that really planted supporting leg, super sharp, so someone could take a picture of you in coupe. Here, 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 and again, again. Boom, boom, boom. And that's as far as we got. Let's try that much. Here we go. Thinking about finding the stretch through the floor. Oh, variations don't look like much, but they're hard, aren't they? All right. Way, way up. And I'll put this next to you so you can help here. Is that going to be in the frame? Sure is. There we go. I suppose, in your most downstage left corner here with your little pas de bourrées, and here's where what we just did at the bar comes in. Oh, excuse me while I catch my breath. We are going to pivot our body straight to the side. You're going to step into your arabesque and pivot to your passe. So first arabesque, opposite arm is leg, you're open to the audience. Pivots into one arm in high fifth, one arm in first position, opposite arm high as leg, okay? So it's arabesque, passe, step, pique arabesque, passe, step, pique arabesque, passe. I think that's it, just three of them. Let's find out actually. Under yourself a little bit here, at least if you're in as small of a space as I am. Three and four. Set it down to fifth. And here come your passe relevés. We're going to move our left foot passe. It's going to come all the way through the front to the back, just like the changing ones we did at the bar. So we change, set it down, change, set it down. There's just two of those, and I'm using my hands as though they're picking up the heel of my foot. Picking up the heel of my foot, really following with the body there, okay? So, four of these. Two, three, four. Pick it up to passe. Pick it up to passe. You know how to do this already. My right foot is in back. I'm going to plie and soutenu fifth position all the way around. And then run. Is that the direction I want to run? Keep the direction going all the way to your upstage corner. Okay. Whew. Let's try that with music. Not easy. So for those arabesques, if you're finding, especially as you're just learning this, that you're having a hard time getting into that passe quickly, you can keep it low. So that means then that you would go 45 coupe, 45 coupe. Yes, totally acceptable because that is quite challenging. All right, we're going to move on, because I think it would be so fun for you to know the whole thing by Christmas, and we're almost done. You can do this for your family in front of the tree on Christmas Day. So, we just finished here. We have our right foot in back in B plus. Okay, here comes another arabesque, and the thing about all of these arabesques is that it doesn't matter how high your leg is, as long as it never gets lower. It can always get higher throughout the movement, but it should never ever get lower. So what we don't want to see, give you a little preview of what you're about to do, is this, with that leg bouncing up and down. All right, we want to see an arrow straight leg wherever it is. If it's at 45, it's staying there and it's not moving, okay? So what these are little chugs in a circle. It's not a full jump. I'm just barely lifting my heel to scoot myself, but I'm going to take it in a circle, okay? So here I am, and I'm gonna find my first arabesque plie, and I'm gonna go jump, two, three, four, to get myself all the way around. So if we're starting to this corner, this is front, then we go to the back corner, to the other back corner, to the front corner, to find our way back to this diagonal we're moving on, okay? So goes chug, two, three, four. Now I'm just going to take this bent leg here and put a little bit of weight in it, and I'm crossing, so we have opposite arm as leg. Okay, I'm just gonna show this without turning first. So I'm gonna go weight in my foot, opposite weight in my foot. It's just a little rock step. Weight in my foot, weight in my foot. But now I'm gonna turn it, okay? So I just did our one, two, three, four. This leg's free to come through. One, two, three. Okay, so we'll go back corner, front corner. And look at that, now this leg's ready to go again, because you have to do these jumps again. One, two, three, four. around in a circle, around in a circle, around in a circle. Oh, I'm sorry, there's a little pot de beurre. Let me listen to this part, Lauren, sorry. Okay, I think that was three of those. So, one, two, three, four. Left foot forward, right foot forward, left foot forward, right foot forward. Is that right? Back, front. Lauren, I'm a mess. What am I thinking? There's only three. Here, let's go here, here, okay? That's super confusing. One, we're just gonna do half turns. One, two, three, bum, bum. Honestly, it doesn't matter how much you turn as long as you find your way back to the front on that. So, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, and just like you did earlier, back foot, front foot, lower. Then you're going to take it again three times, okay? And I'm just going to rush right on because I know you can handle it because you already actually know this part. So say you finished your third one, you're going to take your attitude here, again here, again here. Find this position, bum, then we'll plie and we'll susu. Okay, so I'm coming up to high fifth. My arms aren't in the frame. Up to high fifth and opening, okay? Woo, that was a lot, I know. So we're here, one, two, three, four. Three of these little chug guys. Back front, three times. Then we take our PK attitudes, which we already know. Two, three, turn to face, plie, susu, flick, okay? Don't worry, we're gonna keep going over this. I just thought it would be fun for you to basically have the whole thing by Christmas. This is by no means the end of looking at this, okay? Let's try the whole thing. We might even have time to do it twice. It's 2 minutes and 6 seconds of variation. Here we go. I guess we won't have time to do it twice. All right. Thank you. next one. That's a killer, because I really didn't edit a lot of it for you. It's for the most part of what a lot of professionals and pre-professionals do, so that's hard. So be patient with yourself as you are learning it, and we will definitely continue to look at it. I wish you a very, very Merry Christmas, and I will see you, oh no, not quite in the new year, just after Christmas. At the very, very end of this year. All right. Have a wonderful day, Lauren. Bye.